Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Biblical Hebrew Foundation. Today I'm going to be speaking to you about worship. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of Luke chapter 17, verses 11 to 19. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus, Yeshua, traveled along the border between Samaria and the Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." And they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, he came back praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus, at Yeshua's feet, and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Jesus, Yeshua asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" So we can see that the other 9 were Israelites, were Jews, and only this foreigner from the nations came back to worship God. Luke chapter 17, verse 19. Then he said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." By the way, the word there in Hebrew for making you well is the word saved you. It's the same word we find in Romans chapter 10, verse 13. Whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. It's the same word, made well or made whole. So we see that this man gets healed physically, but then he comes and expresses his faith, and he says, Jesus tells him, "Your faith has saved you and made you completely well physically and spiritually." It's an amazing passage. This man expresses his love to the Lord. We all want to do this. It's in our heart. Everybody wants to be a worshiper. We want to express our love to Yeshua. What caused this guy to express his love? So I started looking for some kind of a track, some kind of a pattern, a formula, if you'd like to call it like that, as I was reading and following this passage. So I want to show you 3 things here about giving thanks. Number 1, gratitude produces worship, and this guy worshiped. He comes with a loud voice. Look at verse 15 and 16. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, returned and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. So he expresses his love to Jesus for what the Lord has done. And I'm not so much speaking here about the outward expressions here as I am the inward, the heart. And his heart was gratitude. And because he had gratitude, he had worship. And I know we all want to be worshipers, so I'm thinking, what produces worship? And when we look at this passage, it's very clear what produces worship. It's gratitude, giving thanks to our Lord Jesus Yeshua. And I want you to think about this for a moment. The man is healed from leprosy. Was it appropriate for him to do what he did, to fall down on his feet, everybody's looking, and to shout and to glorify God and say, "Thank you, God," with a loud voice? Was that appropriate? Well, sure it was. But the question is it scripturally appropriate? In the Old Testament, there are 11 Hebrew words that are translated for praise, but 7 are very dominant. They're the primary ones. So I want to show you here the 7 Hebrew words. I want you to look at the meaning of the words translated into praise. The first word is todah, and it means a thanksgiving choir. Sometimes it's translated to the word thanksgiving, but also into praise. The second word is the word barach, and it means to kneel in thanksgiving. So the word barach is to kneel in thanksgiving, but barach also means to bless. So to bless, to kneel in thanksgiving. The third word is the word tehillah, and it means to sing a song of thanksgiving. Tehillah, to sing a song in thanksgiving. Could be in thanksgiving, of thanksgiving, both the same. And the fourth word is hallel. And hallel means to give thanks by being clamorously foolish. And hallel is where we get our word hallelujah from. And the fifth word is yada, and it means to give thanks with extended hands. So we can see there's a pattern here of giving thanks. And the word yada also comes from the root word yad, which is hand or hands. So to give thanks with extended hands. we can see that it's scriptural to extend your hands when you give thanks to God, when you praise God. And the sixth word is zamar, and it means to give thanks with a musical instrument. The worship team usually does that. They give thanks with a musical instrument. It's the word zamar. And the seventh word is the word shabach, which means to give thanks in a loud tone. Sometimes it can mean also a loud shout or a loud tone. Let's give a shabach to the Lord. So we can see, according to the Hebrew word of the translation of praise, it's scriptural to shout, to extend your hand to God, to kneel, to sing to Him. And when you take these seven words, it's amazing because there's one verse in the Old Testament that has four out of the seven. Amazing. Four out of the seven Hebrew words in one Bible verse. Psalms 100, verse 4. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. Okay, that word over there, thanksgiving, is the word todah in Hebrew. And it means in Hebrew a thanksgiving choir. The word for praise there is the word tehillah, singing praises. Be thankful, that is the Hebrew word there, yada, which means extend your hands. And bless, barach, bow, before His name. Let me rephrase this in Hebrew by just the definition. Let me paraphrase it in the Hebrew. Enter into His gates with a thanksgiving choir and into His courts with singing praises. Be thankful by extending your hands to Him and bless Him by bowing before His name. That's an amazing verse when you understand the meaning of praise and worship in the Hebrew. It's just saying express your love to God. I want to make something clear. We understand that not everybody expresses the love to Yeshua in the same way. Not supposed to be all clamorous, foolish together or bow at the same time. But the purpose of this teaching is to express your love to God, to give thanksgiving to God. We all have different gifts and different personalities, but we still need to express our love and our thanksgiving to God. And one of the main reasons it's so difficult for people to express their love to Yeshua is because many people grew up in a dysfunctional family. That's one of the main reasons. Many people grew up in a family that did not express love. I've heard that from so many people. I never heard my father say, "I love you." Or we never hugged in our family. We were not an expressive family. We did not express our love. I've heard that over and over. I understand that, but please hear what I'm going to say. You're in a new family now. You have been adopted into the family of God. You are not in a dysfunctional family anymore. Your father is not dysfunctional. And according to the Bible, we're the bride of Yeshua. Your husband is not dysfunctional, and I'm speaking in the spiritual aspect. You have entered into the family of Yeshua HaMashiach. You've entered into spiritually Israel as the one new man. So we're not saying that everybody has to express their love in the same way, but I am saying that every person needs to express their love to God. And that's what true worship is. So we all want to be worshipers. What produces worship? Gratitude. This guy in the book of Luke that had leprosy expressed his gratitude and he worshiped. And then what produces gratitude? Miracles produce gratitude. So gratitude produces worship and miracles produce gratitude. It's clear. It says in verse 17:15, and when he saw that he was healed, then he returned and he glorified God with a loud voice. When we receive a miracle, we're grateful. The extent of this miracle was amazing. Today, it's very difficult for us to understand what leprosy is, but this was a huge miracle. Let me share a few things about leprosy. Leprosy is a disease that they thought for years causes your flesh to rot away. So leprosy causes your nerves to numb, and then you get a sore, and you don't feel it. And when the people had open wounds, the rats would come in and would eat the flesh, but they couldn't feel it. And that's what was causing the flesh to rot away. So this was a terrible disease. So today we don't so much know about this disease because we have medical cures, but at that time it was a terrible disease, and you can understand what a miracle this was. If you were a leper in the days of Yeshua, you could not hold a job because you couldn't be around people because it was very, very contagious. You had to keep a distance from every person. So when you had leprosy in those days, you were an outcast. You lost your life. You were separated. You were separated from your family, from your wife, from your children. And if someone didn't know that you were there and they were getting close to you, it was a law that you had to shout, unclean. Can you imagine having to announce that you're an unclean person? If there's anyone that has to shout unclean, it's everyone until Jesus, Yeshua, comes, cleans us, makes us white as snow. And that's what happened here. He was unclean. Yeshua made him clean. And with gratitude, he worshiped and thanked the Lord. If we were living in the time of Yeshua, of Jesus, and we were unclean, we had leprosy, and Jesus healed us, would we express our love in thanksgiving and worship? Of course we would. Well, we all had leprosy. We were all unclean, and Yeshua saved us. And therefore, we all have to raise our hands in gratitude, bow our knee, and worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua. So gratitude produces worship. Miracles produce gratitude. What produces miracles? Obedience produces miracles. Look at Luke 17:14 again. So when he saw them, he said to them, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And so it was that as they went, they were cleansed. Or better yet, the Hebrew says, as they obeyed. Think about this. He said, go show yourselves to the priests. They could have said, we're not healed, because we're not allowed to show ourselves to the priests until we get healed. But they didn't. They acted in obedience. When they obeyed, they were healed. This is all through the Bible. They get up to the Red Sea, and God says to Moses, lift up your rod, hold the stick up, and watch what happens. You just obey and the miracle's on the way. They're going into the promised land. Joshua is bringing them in. They're going through the Jordan. The Jordan is at flood stage. So they get there and the Lord gives them this instruction. Put your foot in the water. You put your foot in and I'll part the water. See, when God speaks, we obey. And when we obey, there's a miracle. And then when there's a miracle, we're grateful. And then we're grateful and we worship. It's as simple as that. Obedience. Yeshua, Jesus, said it with his own mouth. Seek first the kingdom of heaven, and everything will be added to you. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let's live a life of giving thanks. Let's live a life of gratitude. And watch what gratitude will do in your life. So I want to encourage you, where is the next step of obedience for you? Because that obedience could release a miracle in your life. It'll release gratitude, and the gratitude will lead to worship and thanksgiving. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Yeshua. Thank you. Thank you for dying on the cross on the tree for our sins, rising on the third day, and by your blood, we are set free and we have full redemption of sins. And we are grateful for our salvation and we worship you. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Jerusalem, Israel, in the mighty name of Jesus Yeshua. Amen.